Hare Krishna. The mind will dissolve our resolve unless we evolve. Suppose we had some very precious object, but it was soluble in some liquid, say in water. And if you keep it in water, then naturally it will dissolve. And if it's some delicacy, some crispy, eatable, if you keep it in a wet environment, it will lose its crispiness, it will lose its taste. So different objects, they need different environments to stay the way they are meant to be. Similarly for us, we often make some resolutions. I'm going to do this, I'm not going to do this. And when we make such resolutions, at that time, initially, because we may hear some talk, we may have some experience, we may see somebody's example, and that may trigger within us, yes, I'm going to do this. So initially we have the inspiration to make that resolution. However, over a period of time, the resolution goes down. Our resolve weakens. And we stop keeping that resolve. Especially at New Year, people make New Year resolutions. And a study found that almost 90% of most people's New Year resolutions were not new. They'd made those resolutions the previous year and they're making it again now because they couldn't keep it for long. So what causes us to not be able to keep our resolutions? It is the mind. The mind is like a universal solvent. And when our resolution is kept in the mind dissolves our resolve. How does it do that? Because when we resolve something, we are focused on one thing. This is what I'm going to do. Or this is what I'm not going to do. But the mind is very distracted. Hey, why not try that? Why not try that? Why not try that? In 2.41 in the Bhagavata, Krishna says, Vyavasayatmika buddhi ekeha kuru nandana bahushakhaya nantasya buddhayo vyavasayinam. It says that for those who are determined, they keep their consciousness fixed on one object. Those are the people who can grow spiritually. Others, because their consciousness is so distracted, they just can't focus. They stay deluded. Now, what is that one reality on which we can fix our mind? The Bhagavad Gita describes time and time that we try to focus our consciousness on Krishna. Tasmat sarveshu kaleshu mamanusmara yuddhecha. Krishna says, whatever external activity we may be doing, for Arjuna it was fighting because he was a martial guardian of society. For us it may be different. Whatever be the activity we may be doing, we need to focus internally on Krishna. And when we focus internally on Krishna, that causes our consciousness to evolve. So, although the mind is like a universal solvent, when we focus our consciousness on Krishna, our consciousness rises upwards. Because the consciousness rises upwards, that means the mind has its default desires, default inclinations, default habits. But we don't get caught in that. Our energy doesn't get dissipated in that. Because when we evolve, our consciousness rises upwards. And when we connect with Krishna, that is the best way to evolve our consciousness. And to the extent our consciousness evolves, to that extent we'll find that we'll be able to keep our resolves. Because the mind will not dissolve that resolve. And not only will we be able to keep our resolves, but over a period of time, the mind will also evolve. And the mind will start focusing on the positive. This is the stage where Krishna says, our inner war ends. This is the stage where our mind becomes our friend. However, to get to that stage, we have to focus not just on making resolves. I will not do this or I will do this. We need to focus first and foremost on the resolve to evolve, to connect with Krishna and to stay connected with Krishna. And by that, as we evolve, our capacity to stick to our resolves will become stronger and stronger. Thank you. Hare Krishna.